Linux Code System is a series of servers, plugins, and tools used to facilitate file, baseband, and IP video workflows. Normally, the system is tightly integrated into a facility's workflows and controlling software, but to demonstrate some of its capabilities, it comes with a basic HTML5 UI, which I'm going to demonstrate today. Linux Code runs Linux, Windows, or OS X. For server deployments, we recommend Linux, but for testing, Windows is fine and will be what I'm using today. To access the demo server, simply point your browser at its IP address. Chrome is recommended, but Safari, Firefox, and IE will work as well. You will see the interface is divided into four main sections, along with a menu area and a status bar at the bottom. The interface is designed to demonstrate streaming, capture, clipping, and partial file restore. We'll go through each of them in order. As a visual aid, I have put all the services in GUI mode, so you'll be able to see them in operation. Normally, they would be run headless. To begin with, we will start some video streaming out to the network. Clicking the Start button in the streaming area will cause NetX Base to signal NetX Command to start NetX Code to stream out three files from disk via RTP. The demo media included with the server includes a group of H.264 files, a 60p 10-bit high bitrate, a 60p low bitrate, and a 30p internet bitrate file. We can check the streaming using VLC. Normally, the streams would come from a variety of encoders, like those from Everts, Hivision, Marshall, and others. Once we have the streams on the network, we can begin to capture them. NetX Code supports capturing the entire stream directly as a transport stream, or real-time rewrapping of the essences into an MXF, MOV, MP4, or other file type. Captures are built up in groups, each one having up to 10 synchronized channels within it. The demo has three groups, the first of which is for capture. It has four channels capturing MXF, MP4, TS, and DASH files. All associated metadata, closed captions, timecode, and reference XML, M3U8, MPD files are captured and updated during the capture. One of the core technologies of NetX Code is the RTIN, or real-time index file. This file allows NetX Code servers, MediaRector plugins, and other tools to access the recording file while it is still recording. It also allows the use of file contents without having to read the entire file for bandwidth-sensitive operations like cloud access or partial file restore. Here I'll bring up the recording proxy in our VideoQC product. I can also use MediaRector to edit the high bitrate MXF and third-party tools like Adobe Premiere, Avid, Scratch, Nucoda, Flame, and many others. The third section is for restreaming the captured files back out to the network. This is useful for running program material to the network, looping moving slates, and for time-delaying streams that are being captured live back to the network. The bottom area has a series of buttons to bring up viewing, clipping, and moving tools. Clicking the View Live Capture button will bring up our NetX Player. NetX Player is a pure HTML5 video player that supports MP4, HLS, DASH, 264 smooth streaming, and most importantly, the live RTIN files. The files we started recording earlier are now listed below the player. Clicking on one of the files will load it into the player. You'll notice the player detects that it is a live file and lights up the live button. Clicking on the live button will seek the playhead to the record head and begin playing. There is full transport control over the playback, including keyboard control. The positioning is all done through frame-accurate timecode, which will exactly match between the proxy, high bitrate, and web-destined files. Clicking the Make Clip button will bring up the NetX player along with a UI to clip and convert media files. Live or pre-recorded material can be selected and played in the player. In and out points can be set as timecode, either frame accurately, or aligned with the nearest iframe. Once the area of interest is chosen, that area can be converted out to a new clip in a number of ways. You can copy the entire file, create an RT index, make a partial file restore with a new file via rewrapping, converting it to standard formats like MXF, MP4, MOV, and many others, and converting to standard codecs like AVCI, XAVC, ProRes, XDCAM, DV100, and many others. Clicking the Clip button will cause NetX Copy to run in the selected server and do the actual rewrapping or conversion and make the new thumbnail. Partial File Restore is very similar to MakeClip, but in this case, the timecode in and out points are found on the MP4 proxy, but the source of the rewrap or conversion is switched to the high-quality, high-bitrate file. This is how most PFR systems work, with the MP4 and RTIN on local servers, and the larger high-quality files on tape, cloud, or slower storage. The huge advantage of Netis Copy Restores is that it only has to read the required audio, video, and captions, as all of the index and header information is stored in the ARTIN files. ARTINs can also be made for any post-production formats and are automatically created when capturing or clipping in NetX code. Finally, NetX code supports handy auxiliary functions like moving files, thumbnail generation, thumbnail retrieval, and proxy generation. The RESTful API can be called from almost any programming language. The demo UI is written in HTML5 with a small amount of PHP to access local drives. NetX code can be demoed on a small, dedicated server, or set up as a trial on one of your in-house servers. For more information, please see www.netxcode.com or contact sales@drastictech.com.